New to Threat Intelligence Management? In this video, you'll learn how to complete your initial configuration so you can take advantage of this feature. As a feature of both Splunk Enterprise Security and Splunk Mission Control, Splunk's Threat Intelligence Management System enables analysts to fully investigate security events or suspicious activity by providing the relevant and normalized intelligence to better understand threat context, improve detections, and accelerate time to triage. Threat Intelligence Management gathers data from multiple intelligence sources, like indicators of compromise and their malicious score. It then aggregates and prepares it so it can be used by Splunk Enterprise Security to improve the quality of detections by searching for known bad actors. Since Threat Intelligence Management runs on Mission Control, analysts using either Enterprise Security or Mission Control can use this data during investigations of events with threat objects that have matching intelligence without leaving Splunk. To get started, within Mission Control, navigate to the Content tab. The very first step in the configuration is to connect to intelligence sources that you have access to. Within the Intelligence menu, click on Sources. The Threat Intelligence Marketplace has native connectivity to several threat intel vendors, with more being added in the future. You also have the option to bring additional intelligence through MISP or TACSI connections. In this menu, you can see the status of existing sources and select new sources to subscribe to. Just click on the desired source and fill in the required information to complete the subscription process. Now that we are connected to our intelligence sources, the next step is to curate the data received from those so it can be used efficiently by our other Splunk tools. Navigate to the Workflows menu for that task. Here, you will see any configured workflows, the sources that they are receiving data from, and the filters that have been configured to process the intelligence from these sources. To create a new workflow, click on the plus workflow button on the top right. On the workflow details screen, add a name to your new intelligence flow and click Next. On the next screen, you will be able to select the sources from which you want to receive intelligence data for this workflow. You can assign different weights to your sources to affect how an indicator's priority score is computed. A larger weight means that sources' maliciousness scores will have a stronger influence over an indicator's final priority score, which is then used to transform and curate your data. Once you're ready, click on Next to move to the next step. In this menu, you can specify filters you'd like the pipeline to apply to the intel source's indicators of compromise based on your desired outcome. For example, you can tell the pipeline to only allow indicators that are scored as a high risk, select all type of indicators that are not any of the trusted URLs, domains, and IP addresses in your pre-configured safe lists. From this screen, you can also add a new safe list library, edit, or delete existing ones. Once you have finished selecting data transformations, you can save your new workflow. During investigations for threat notables that already exist, users can use the Intelligence Management action to open up the Mission Control Intelligence panel. In this panel, a list of threat objects related to the event will be displayed on the left. Click on each one to see if any additional intelligence is available. For example, this indicator has been reported by this source as malicious. This makes it easier for analysts to gain additional context during their investigations without leaving Splunk. Now that your intelligence is connected to your tools, visit our docs website for additional questions and stay tuned for updates on new intelligence sources and capabilities. Thank you for watching.